Hi everyone, I'm Randall Vickerson. The story goes that the famous shogun, Ashikaga Yoshimasa, in the 15th century, had a favorite Chinese tea bowl. And that Chinese tea bowl broke. So he had the Chinese tea bowl sent off to China to have it repaired. And when it returned, it was repaired with these ugly metal staples holding it together. Now, this prompted the Japanese craftsmen and artisans of the day to develop a more aesthetically pleasing way to repair pottery and repair broken ceramics. And this is the development of the art form of Kintsugi. Now, the philosophy here is very much connected and in the context of the Japanese aesthetic known as wabi-sabi, and less about the Western ideals of perfection and symmetry and geometry. And the art form is joining up the pottery using precious metals, gold, platinum. And what they're doing here is actually bringing your attention to those imperfections. The eye is immediately drawn to the imperfections and to where that pottery has been broken. And it's also connected to some of the Buddhist concepts of impermanence, that these pieces of imperfection that you can visibly see in the pottery or in the object represent the actual history of the object. And I think about that in terms of the context of resilience, and I think about the challenges that we've all experienced in our own lives. Loss of loved ones, loss of relationships, loss of financial security or loss of a job, loss of one's home country. And a resilient skill is really looking at and celebrating those challenges that we've had. And I've certainly spoke to many, and I have those moments in my own life, though I felt like I may have been broken through those moments and really been challenged about how difficult and painful they may have been. But at the same time, I think they add value to my life and add meaning to my life. And this is very much in the Kintsugi art form, is that you can take an object. And the art form became very famous for just taking the ordinary object and making it much more beautiful than it was before. And when we talk about resilience, it is looking at our experiences in life and what have we learned from those experiences and how have they contributed to who we are today, as much as they were challenging and difficult at the time. So I think Kintsugi, the art form, is just such a poetic manifestation of how one can view our lives. And we'll talk more about this in an upcoming free webinar we have. Please check out the date and the time and click on the link to register. We'll talk about this and other ways to keep and strengthen your own resilience. Thanks so much.